Hello guys, it's Zaku Amps, so welcome back on my channel. I'm sorry that I didn't post a video last week, but I was really tired and I had a lot of appointments and I had a show with my choir, so I was really, really exhausted. And I am still exhausted for other reasons, so I'm sorry if I don't have a lot of energy in this video, but I just had my second shot for the vaccine yesterday and I am super, super tired. I had like shivers all night and I did sleep, but like I feel really lethargic. I'm not like at my best, but I don't have a lot of options this week to record a video, and I want to cheer myself up painting something and just chit chat with you guys. I'm gonna just talk about these first and then we're gonna just keep on working as I talk again about my life. For this piece, I'm gonna work with my Himi gouache. What I did for this, basically in the first layers, I had just like strips of pink, and then I wanted to work abstract, so I worked with the purple first. And for some reason, I don't know what came to me, but I just wanted to paint mushrooms. So I started to paint one mushroom, and then I painted a forest. And I tried to work with a different color palette, which I don't do usually. And so this is why I end up with this pink, purple, and blue concept art, which I really, really like. It is quite different from what I usually do. I mean, I do use pink and blue a lot, but I don't do certain color palettes like this. It is a bit different. There's still a lot to do on this piece. I want to just add more details, and we had a bit more mushrooms in some places, just blend things a bit more, define it a bit more. It's still going to be like a concept art thing, so I'm not gonna do a lot more, but I still wanna finish this. My brother also had his second shot vaccine like 2 weeks ago or something, and he had no side effects. My other brother also didn't have any side effects. I'm the only one who is sick. And I also combined that with medication from my diabetes that makes me nauseous. And the last thing on that is I have my period right now. So 3 in a row, that's a bit much for my system. So that's why I'm not feeling the best, but I still want to paint. And I also had, like I said, I had a lot of medical appointments. So if you have been following me for a while and you've seen my videos where you can see me, you notice maybe that I do have issues with my vision. I have what's called a strabismus, I think it's in English. So basically my left eye is not aligned, and I had that since I was like 9 years old. It's pretty old. I had surgery to fix it. Anyways, I don't know how to speak English. My brain isn't functioning, so I'm gonna go in like short story. I had an appointment to go deep in like analyzing my vision and with like different doctors and all, just to see if I could get another surgery to fix this alignment for my left eye. And I went, and like it took like nearly 2 hours to test it out. So I do have now a new prescription for my glasses because I don't have the right correction. So I have that. And the other thing that I found out on Monday with the other appointment with the actual surgeon is that I am actually a good candidate for another surgery that will fix my eye, and technically my eyes, because he is going to operate both eyes in order to adjust the muscle tension, because your eyes function in, it's hard to explain in French, yeah, the lot, like in English it's impossible for me, but basically my brain is actually unable to see 3D, which means that my eyes don't function together. They're like completely dissociated, which is why I haven't been able to control my vision, like they're not aligned. So what he told me, if I'm understood correctly, is that he'll be able to fix the alignment, but it's not going to fix my ability to see 3D, because that is my brain doing the job. It's not my eyes. It's your brain who transforms the images you see. And so that was pretty cool to find out, because I thought that I'll be completely unable to ever have a surgery to fix my vision. And it is pretty like I've lived with it for nearly 30 years, so it's not a huge, huge deal. The people who know me know, they know that I have one eye that is not really working well. But aesthetically, and for self-esteem, and just overall, I feel like it will improve my quality of life. And I also have lost part of my vision on my right eye, and I don't want to end up blind at like 50 years old. And he wasn't really concerned about that. The surgeon told me like I was like slightly losing some of my vision, but it's not that bad. And so yeah, that is a pretty big news. The only thing that he thought that would make me sad is that I have to wait. I'm on a waiting list because there's a lot of people waiting for surgery, so I'm gonna have to wait until 2022, so basically next year, to get the surgery, which is fine with me. I mean, literally, I've been waiting for like 25 years, so I think I'm okay, you know, just waiting a tiny bit more. But yeah, that is a big thing. Like, I'm signing up for it. You know, of course, I will do what it takes to fix it. In terms of cost, I'm not sure because I haven't talked about it to the surgeon, but in France, we do have a pretty good English medical system, so I should be covered by my health insurance. And I also have type 2 diabetes, so maybe it is considered something to be covered because of that. I have no idea about that, but I don't really care about the cost, to be honest. Even if I have to pay for the actual surgery, I will do it because it is important for me. Like I said, I am not feeling the best, so pardon me if I'm not making much sense right now. And I also think I need to focus on this painting because I can't really talk and paint at the same time. I wanna thank you guys for the feedback on my last videos, especially the last one, but if you haven't seen it, I will link it somewhere. You really liked that I tried something else, and I was really happy with the results, and I'm really happy that you guys enjoyed everything. I will get into my book after July 15th, and I will probably record a video where I talk a bit more about the storyline and the characters and all of that. It is pretty much a work in progress still, and there's a lot of things that I want to work on. So it's not like set in stone, basically. So that is still going on, but I can give you the general baseline and the actual characters, because characters are pretty developed already. The story, though, needs a bit more layers. Lastly, before I jump into actually diving into completing this piece and not talking to you guys because I can't do both, I just wanted to also tell that the reason why I haven't been really online the last weekend and this weekend too is because I had shows for my choir, and it was pretty exhausting. But I was in the front line for the first time, in the basically just the first line of like singers. And I, for the next show on Saturday, I was actually moved back to the second line. And I was really, really sad and upset about it. So I've asked the person who's in charge of just placing everybody if there was something that I did wrong, or is there a reason why I am not in the front. And she basically told me that because I made mistakes during the choreography, overall, like, it wasn't super precise. It didn't really work with me being in the front, so they want to try putting someone else, and I'm back to where I was, which is second line. And that's because I basically failed. And I was really upset because I really did my best and I worked really hard, and it was my first time being in the front, and so it was really like nerve-wracking. And I felt really judged by the process. And the main reason why I'm going to this choir in the first place is to have fun and enjoy myself and not feel like a piece of crap because I failed and like I made some mistakes, because I wasn't the only one who screwed up. Sure, I'm completely open with the fact that we can turn things around. It's just not very fair, and not everybody is treated the same way. And like, I don't want to fight about the fact that I did mess up, so of course, I'm clearly not fully ready to be in the front, which is okay, I will just keep on working. But I don't like the fact that basically they put somebody else
who hasn't done any shows, who's new, who hasn't been practicing because she missed a lot of rehearsals, and I don't really get why they put that person. Now, I'm hoping that she can pull that off and that she'll be okay in the front row or the front line, because I wouldn't want to be in her shoes because I think she's going to feel a lot of pressure. But I'm just really confused because even though I made mistakes, I'm still like the most ready. So I didn't really understand their decision, even though I also feel mostly upset at myself because I screwed up. It was really hard yesterday to not feel discouraged, and we have another show coming. And I was really sad because my family is coming and they're not going to see me in the front. I don't know, you feel like you're putting yourself in a position where you feel really stressed out and you're doing your best and you're trying really hard and it's not enough. And you're put back into a B position even though you try to be in the front. And I felt really judged and I felt like I suck, even though she also told me that everything else was good. So I know that I can improve on that, but it's hard. It was really hard to combine with how I felt mentally and physically with the shot and all the things that I've been going through these past days. It was a bit hard to find out that I've basically messed up and I'm paying the price of just not being allowed to be in the front, which is not a good feeling to have. It's not a big deal. Trust me, there are like a lot of worse things. Ultimately, I'm not like mad at it. I'm just disappointed at myself, mainly. But I also want to do my best to have fun and relax. And I'm not going to have as much pressure being in the second line instead of in the front line. So that's a good thing in a way. Lastly, my coloring book is coming end of the month. But I have an art book coming for the fall. And I don't want to release back-to-back two books. So I am finishing up the book in the next 2 weeks. If it's not coming out at the end of July, I probably will still postpone that to September because I don't think getting something out in August is a good move. But for my next coloring book, I'll try my best to work ahead on stuff so I can get it out for spring 2022. Because I don't like being in a rush all the time. It is really stressful. It's a lot of work, but still, like, I'm not really happy with how I'm managing stuff right now. But I just had a lot on my mind medically, and I'm feeling a lot better. I'm taking actions to actually feel better, but it's a lot of work, and it takes a lot of time to take care of yourself. So that is why. And if you'd like to make sure to not miss the release date, I will encourage you to subscribe to my mailing list. I will put the link below. That way you have premium releases. I will probably make a discount code for those who came from the mailing list. So if you'd like to get your hands on like a 10% off, that would be a great idea. I feel a bit better talking about all of those things, making progress into this piece. And thank you guys for listening to me rambling about my life. But to be honest, I don't feel bad. I feel like sick, but I don't really feel bad. I feel better because I had great news. I am losing weight. My cat is happy and healthy. My family is also healthy. My friends are doing okay. And yeah, I'm just going through the motions and trying my best to not get the anxiety over the roof for stuff that doesn't really matter. And I think I'll be better when the side effects are just wore off. I can rest and just have time with my family. Anyways, a very long explanation. I'm hoping you'll still like watching, but now I'm just gonna go hard finishing this, put some music on, and you get to enjoy the rest of the painting. So thank you guys for watching this video. Enjoy, and I'll see you next week.